欢迎收看旁观华尔街视角。今天华尔街开始呈现了一个盘整，那么整体市场走势到底如何，是我们今天关注的焦点。那么通过我阅读的一些文章，看到股神巴菲特实际上他有一个量股票市场风险的指数，那么这个指数呢，是用目前股票市场市值与国内生产总值的季度的总值来进行一个比较，看是增长幅度是比差是多少。那如果说是股票市场价格太高，超过国内生产总值增长的话，那么就显示这个指数已经预示了股票市场风险过高，现在可能会面临大幅盘整甚至是崩盘的这个威胁。如果说是增长的相对来说呢，比经济增长超低的话，就证明股票市场现在过于悲观，会有些投资人趁低大幅入场。如果说是基本相当的话，那当然现在是处在一个合理的一个状况。那么股神巴菲特非常相信的这个指数，曾经准确的预测了2000年网络泡沫导致崩盘的一个风险系数，同时在2008年又预测了因为是次贷导致的金融风暴，当时股票市场的参数是大大超出于国内生产总值。那么现在是2000年，它已经又开始接近高位，达到187%，当然不知道最高是多少，这是文章没有透露，就证明现在已经是又进一步超高，所以市场风险现在是相当的大。不过呢，文章也指出，今年的情况似乎同往年不同。首先是疫情使经济突然的停摆，那么导致的随后国内生产总值的大幅的跳升，跟目前股票市场大幅上升，因为各个行业受到疫情的侵袭影响的一种反应不同所导致的结果，似乎不能很正常的是表现出目前市场和股票市场之间的这个风险的系数。另外一个原因就是在股票市场现在出现大幅上升的很多公司，实际上他们的收入并不取决于国内生产总值，而是来自于国际市场，而且是一种趋势已经是越来越明显。所以股票市场的增长幅度与国内生产总值增长的比例是不是那么密切的准确的息息相关呢？大概现在要画一个问号。不过市场确实是一个风险的这个系数有增高的迹象，因为从十年长债啊，我们昨天的专家米绍施奈特就表示，要关注的四大焦点之一，其中之一就是长债收益率。目前长债收益率开始出现反弹，早上一开盘是0.95%，收盘是0.94%，但是总之是向1%靠近。这就显示，债券市场是有资金溢出，所以呢，这个才提升收益率来吸引更多的投资人。那么，债券的价格呈现下降，价格和收益率是成反比的。那就是说，现在市场还是风险系数不断增高。那么今后走势如何呢？也就是2021年，因为现在已经是12月底12月份了，马上进入圣诞节，大概交易也没有几天，那投资人还是要看长远迹象的。所以我们今天的这个交易专家是南达科达基金的高级投资组合的经理Robert Pavlik。 首先他给我们分析现在市场对他来说在告诉大家一个什么样的迹象。
The market is telling you that it clearly believes that 6 months to a year down the road, things are going to be better, not only on the coronavirus, but hopefully on the economy, the hope for some type of stimulus, the vaccine being administered to folks around the world. The market is telling you that things are looking brighter.
接下来我们要讨论的问题就是投资策略。在疫情的时候，很多大型股呢已经出现相当大的升幅，这两天都是连连走跌，其中包括 Zoom， 还包括像亚马逊和特斯拉，还等等一些大型的高科技股。那这些股我们以后怎么样看待他们的走势呢？
The momentum driven names, the stocks that had sort of powered the market forward in 2020, I think are probably going to haveto see some give up as folks rotate into the early cyclicals or quote value trade. Now, does that mean you have to exit out of things that have worked in 2020, like technology and consumer discretionary and communication? I don't believe that you have to, but I think you have to sort of be a little bit more cautious in your holdings on some of those areas. Again, if Zoom was the power to the market in 2020 because people were shut in or the economy was locked down and people weren't going into the office, how is that going to perform when people go back to the office, start having face-to-face meetings, people get back on airplanes to conduct business? There will be a place for Zoom, but I don't believe it's going to be sort of the forerunner to the market as it was in 2020. And I don't mean to necessarily pick on Zoom, but because these are momentum trades, the momentum can swing both ways. So I think you have to be careful with some of these names. But companies that have powered the market for years, for instance, Apple or Adobe or Microsoft, just focusing on technology, these are the companies that I think are going to continue to survive. Amazon clearly has the power of internet shopping behind it, like Alibaba does. Tesla is a name that people look at and think that this is the future. People who are drawn to a Tesla stock aren't necessarily looking at the valuations, but they're looking at the leadership of the company, the potential for change on a global basis. They are drawn to that particular name because they're Tesla followers, such as Apple was in the beginning when Jobs announced the iPhone and iPod. But I wouldn't put them sort of in the same category, even though they're both consumer discretionary. One name is changing the world and the way people shop and making it more convenient. And Tesla is changing the world, but just in a different manner. And I think they draw in similar but different investors.
好，以上就是今天内容，谢谢你的收看，祝您身体健康，保护自己，防御疫情。我们下次再见。